Hello guys, my name is Luca and today I will make a full review about the LG SN10Y soundbar, one of LG best soundbars. The LG SN10Y is basically a 5.1.2 channel surround with subwoofer that supports Dolby Atmos and DTS:X along with high resolution audio, HDMI, eARC, USB, Bluetooth streaming, wireless connectivity, and the ability to use extra dedicated surround speakers and expand the system to 7.1.2 channels. With 570 watts of total power and different sound modes, this soundbar will amaze you. These features come at a hefty price at around 1000 bucks, but let's see if it's worth it and if there is some better soundbar at this price range. The main unit of the LG soundbar have 3 front-firing drivers, 2 up-firing Atmos drivers, and 2 side-firing drivers that are responsible for the surround effects, along with a powerful subwoofer that produces great low frequencies and offers a great sound profile that's well suited for movies or music, and as well as a variety of sound enhancement features. The main soundbar unit is extremely big and weighs at 7.2 kg, but this big size places the SN10Y amongst the most powerful units in the soundbar industry. The front and side firing drivers are covered by a full covering perforated metal grille, while the rest of the main body, including the top, is made from plastic that has a brushed metal finish, giving it a more premium look, same as the subwoofer, and feature straight lines. At the top of the main unit, placed in the center, are the usual built-in buttons that almost all soundbars have and are touch sensitive, arranged in the straight line with 2 small holes above them that features the built-in microphone for the voice control functionality. The built-in touch sensitive buttons on the main unit include a power button, a function button for selecting input source, volume controls, and Wi-Fi button. This soundbar comes with a fully working display that LG placed in the right side of the main soundbar unit and show various information like input source and volume, amongst others. This soundbar has a wide selection of physical inputs, and you can even use it as a hub between your TV and other devices. It has 2 HDMI inputs along with a 1 HDMI output, which has eARC functionality but doesn't have AUX input, so you can't directly connect older devices to the bar. On the upside, it does have an USB port, which is handy if you have music stored on a thumb drive or external drive. The soundbar profile is relatively low and it doesn't obstruct the TV IR sensor. The LG subwoofer is not as big as you would imagine for such a huge soundbar or the box that came with it, but is good enough to fit in most spaces. It's about the size of an average desktop PC and weighs about 7.8 kg. At the back, we find the power cable, a power button in case it lost its connection with the main unit, and a large bass port. Fabric covers 3 sides of it, but it can rip or collect dust. It connects to the bar wirelessly, so you can place it anywhere as you like, as long as it is connected to a power source. The main soundbar unit are a combination of 40 by 100 mm woofer along with a 20 mm silk dome tweeters for each of the 3 front firing channels, along with a couple more 40 by 100 mm woofer each used for the side firing channels, and 2 2.5 inch woofers used for the up firing Atmos channel, so keep both sides of the soundbar not to be obstructed in order to for the side-firing surround drivers to work their best. The subwoofer has a single 7-inch speaker and can go pretty loud that will certainly satisfy you. The output power of the soundbar and the subwoofer is rated at a total of 570 watts of RMSE power. In the package is included a remote control, which provides all the necessary buttons in order to control both the soundbar functions. LG has been using the same remote as the cheaper model and only changes the buttons layout depending on the soundbar functionality. At the top, shaped in the power symbol, we find the power on-off button with two large buttons below that control the volume, mute sound and circle through function and input button. Under this, there are three circular playback buttons that you can use them while streaming music, while below them are a group of six buttons that handle different functions like sound effects, sound tuning, information, repeat, as well as folder selection. The buttons have usually the rubber feel and their big size made it easier to press the right one. It supports Atmos, giving you a more immersive sound experience, and for getting the most of this soundbar and enable the Dolby Atmos, you need to connect the soundbar through HDMI input and give it a 4K sound signal. It uses upfiring speakers on the bar to bounce sound off the ceiling and back down towards you to give you the illusion of height. However, this doesn't sound as real as a discrete localization provided by a two-firing speaker that you will find in home theater setups. Atmos is a sound format that adds elevation to your sound, so the sound goes from left to right, from front to back, and from up to down. That makes this soundbar special. The most important sound feature is the AI sound mode, which lets the soundbar automatically optimize sound and is for those that don't want to mess with sound options all the time. It automatically adjusts sound level, bringing out treble or bass based on what you're listening. Bluetooth streaming is also available, which means you can stream music from any mobile device like a smartphone or tablet to your soundbar. After you mount the soundbar, you will forget it because this soundbar has the CAC function and being connected via HDMI ARC turns on and off with the TV, and even the sound is controlled directly from the TV remote. So just one remote. The soundbar has incredible support via its HDMI ARC port and it supports most common audio format. It also supports eARC, so it's able to play high quality lossless format. You can watch Dolby Digital content, which is the most found surround sound format, as well as most advanced object-based formats like Dolby Atmos and DTS:X. It's not the chest pumping performance that dedicated subwoofer can offer, but for its size and power, it will shake your house and make the neighbors know what you are listening. If you look at the LG SN10Y performance, certainly for the casual user it will be more than enough, but the price is pretty high for a soundbar system, even for one as advanced as this one, and you can find, in my opinion, some better soundbars like JBL Bar 9.1 or Samsung Q958 that is in the same price range. Thanks to its full array of physical inputs and wireless connectivity options, it is of use. This soundbar, it remains an excellent top-of-the-line soundbar. Conclusion: if I had $1,000 and an LG Smart TV, I would buy it. But if I don't really want to buy the LG brand, I will opt for the JBL Bar 9.1 with Atmos. What is your impression? Feel free to join my YouTube channel and please hit that like button.